Hello, Internet. This is OscarVice again, continuing our series on minimization, this time looking at dichotomous search. We'll show how it improves on ternary search, go over the algorithm, and also discuss an example. You will need to have some familiarity with ternary search. I recommend checking out my video. Recall with ternary search, we always check the values of the functions between C and D, deciding on which interval to keep. Note that the new interval is going to be two-thirds the size of the old one. If we instead move our C and D values to be within epsilon distance of each other, I'm exaggerating it here, we can actually improve a lot on ternary search. Now, when we check if f of C is less than f of D, our new interval is going to be about half the size of our old one. This is the basis of dichotomous search. From our interval, we want to compute the midpoint, m, which is a plus b over 2, giving us this value. Then, to the left and right, we'll compute c and d by subtracting epsilon over 2 and adding epsilon over 2. This means our distance between c and d is epsilon. As an example, let's just say that f of c was less than f of d, giving us this new interval, which is about half the size of the old one. We would then repeat the process. When that was not the case, and f of c was greater than or equal to f of d, we would choose this as our new interval and repeat the process, still about half the size of our old one. Let's look at Optimum Seeking Methods by Wild. In it, the author writes, "When there are only two experiments, the best thing to do is place both experiments at the center of the interval, as close together as possible. This leaves an interval of uncertainty of length 1 half plus epsilon over 2. Suppose we place the third and fourth experiments in the middle of the remaining interval. Then the interval uncertainty would be given by 1 quarter plus 3 epsilon over 4. After a fifth and sixth experiment placed in a similar fashion, the interval will be down to 1 eighth plus 7 epsilon over 8. Imagine once we get close to the actual minimum, our distance between D and C is still epsilon, but now look how close A is to C and D is to B. After the next iteration, for an example, the distance between C and D is still epsilon, but we haven't shrunk our distance for the other two very much. The next iteration will still be epsilon distance away. In fact, we're not getting very close to stopping. Because D minus C is always equal to epsilon, and A is always less than C, and D is always less than B, our usual end condition of B minus A less than epsilon isn't going to work. We'll instead want to use B minus A over 2 less than some epsilon. The algorithm for a dichotomous search will look strangely familiar to those who've seen ternary search. We start with some unimodal function, f, and an interval, A and B. Then, use our new end condition of B minus A over 2 less than some epsilon. Once the case, we found our minimum of a plus b over 2, and we can stop. Otherwise, we'll compute a new midpoint of a plus b over 2, then use c and d to left and right of m. Afterwards, check if f of c is less than f of d. When it is, we'll move d into b, and when it isn't, we'll move c into a, then repeat the process. Using our same example from ternary search, if we run a dichotomous search, this only needs 19 iterations to find our final interval, A and B. Meanwhile, ternary search required 34. Some important takeaways are that dichotomous search is still guaranteed to find a minimum, and it's going to do so faster than ternary search, still with a linear order, reducing the search space by about half every iteration. It still requires two function calls per iteration, and does have a different terminal condition. If that really bothers you, you can always switch to ternary search once you get really close. There are still other ways to find a minimum, such as Fibonacci search and golden section search, but those are topics for their own videos. The code that I used will be hosted on GitHub. As always, thank you for watching. I will be uploading the videos for Fibonacci search and golden section search soon, so be sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss them.